What is up? Felix Wehr here for Thomann Synthesizers, here from our studios in Berlin. And with me again today is ASEC, who recently has already been here and delivered a really beautiful performance. So definitely go check that out in case you missed it. And today you are back with your setup here because you want to talk about a subject that interests you a lot.
Well, we're going to talk about variations in electronic music. Mm-hmm. So I think variations are kind of really important because somehow one critique of electronic music is that it sounds repetitive or boring. We all know that that's not necessarily true.
Yeah.
But I think variations really help you to add dynamism and interest to mm-hmm. static loops. And yeah. I really like to use subtle sort of shifting variations. Mm-hmm. And I think why variations are important is because variations are the thing that keeps you listening.
Yeah.
Even when maybe you don't know why you're continuing to listen through, you know, from the kind of slow LFO movements in your favorite electronic music track to your mm-hmm. really sickly sweet key changes in your favorite pop music.
Yeah.
Variations are the thing that keeps you interested.
Yeah.
Cool. So I guess I want to talk about a few different kinds of variation, and I'm going to start with modulation.
Mm-hmm.
So probably people already know what modulation is and how to use it, but I'll maybe just go through a little bit of what I'm doing.
Yeah.
So I like to use two kinds of modulation, I guess. So as I was saying, I like to do this long evolving type of modulation, so mm-hmm. very slow movements. On parameters,
yeah,
as
so like
well.
Super, super slow LFOs.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. And then I also like to use random sequences and mm-hmm. signals to change parameters in ways that were unexpected and that can never be repeated
yeah.
in the same phrase. So yeah, why don't we talk about some of the long evolving modulations first.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is maybe make a patch from my Dopfer quad LFO here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to patch this to a parameter on the Moog DFAM.
Yeah.
Cool. And I really love the DFAM because it's really...
It's a drummer from another
Exactly.
Moog.
It's the Moog drum machine, but I tend to use it as more of a lead synth.
Yeah.
So you can hear that's moving now, it's playing.
So now it's sequenced by the Arturia?
Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. So it's just, there's a polyrhythmic sequence coming in from this Arturia beat step.
Ah, so you only have five steps
exactly.
and then it repeats. Yeah, sick.
So it's just five steps.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to patch this triangle wave here.
So this already is in a sense a kind of endless variation because
exactly.
the one constantly shifts and you don't really, you totally. Are not really able to tell where exactly the
Absolutely.
Pattern begins and ends.
Absolutely. Yeah, and I think like polyrhythm is not something that I would talk about today, but something that
yeah.
You can definitely use to make some patterns sound much more interesting.
Yeah.
So yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to patch this triangle wave here to, let's say, the noise level mm-hmm. on the DFAM. So now you should start to hear the noise rise and
ah,
fall.
Yeah.
And it's such a simple technique, and it's maybe nothing new
yeah.
to anybody.
So if
at
I
home.
Increase the frequency now, the change is going to be
Absolutely,
more.
Exactly.
All right. Yeah.
And you could even go one step further and modulate this parameter if you wanted to.
Yeah. Oh, true.
But again, I think that's really the point. It's like
yeah.
the long, slow, evolving modulations. And I think this is a very simple example. But if you
yeah.
Take each parameter that you're modulating and add the slow modulation over time, you end up with something really powerful that shifts in a
yeah.
pseudo-random way
yeah.
That starts to sound really interesting.
Yeah. There's also a lot of LFOs actually already built inside the rhythm.
Exactly,
yeah?
exactly. And it's maybe something we could look at.
Yeah.
So what I want to do is, one thing that I like to do, I guess, is that I like to map the random LFO inside the analog rhythm from
mm-hmm.
Electron to the sample slot on the sample menu.
Oh, so it changes the actual sound that's being
Exactly,
played.
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
So this is something that I find quite interesting. So I'll choose the sample slot here.
Yeah.
Oops.
Because you have like I think 128 sample slots
exactly.
On every track of this.
Exactly. So if I move to the sample slots now,
yeah.
I have basically loaded a bunch of industrial samples. When I mean industrial, I don't mean industrial techno. I mean
yeah.
sounds from a building site that were recorded.
Yeah.
So what it's going to do basically is it's going to play through each sound at a random interval basically. So
that's pretty creative.
I turn this on. I'm going to add some steps here. I'll turn off the thing here. And then now all I need to do is turn the depth.
Ah.
So now basically it sounds different every time through the loop.
Yeah.
It sounds quite breaky.
Yeah.
It's definitely something you can use to get variations. something I like to do as well is if it doesn't necessarily sound so coherent, so maybe just a little bit of delay to fill in the gaps, you know? Exactly. And it sounds more rhythmic. Sounds a little bit more rhythmic. So yeah, I think that's something that I really like to use, and maybe not on every step, but just a little bit here and there, yeah. And kind of let the decay of the sample roll out as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, I guess that's like how I would use maybe sort of random modulations at least. Another thing that I find really interesting is volumes and velocity.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of an underlooked or overlooked parameter somehow, but like what we're trying to do here is we're really thinking about how to mimic or like humanize music almost, and that's where the variation comes.
Yeah.
And I think velocity is a really amazing tool to do that.
Yeah.
So I'm just gonna turn this down a little bit. What I could do is maybe make a 16 step hi-hat sequence. Mm-hmm. There's already one in here. And this sounds super static right now. So I'm wondering if what we could do is maybe change the velocities as well as changing the volumes to add some feel or like humanized feel into this. So I use the trigger menu on Analog Rhythm and I will literally just sort of pseudo randomly change the velocities. And you should start to feel a little bit more like a real drummer. And that's just a 16 step sequence and it sounds a little bit different.
Much more, maybe.
So then I will also do the same, some on the volumes as well.
Mm-hmm.
And it starts to feel a little bit more like a drummer playing in a studio.
Yeah.
And this is a thing I really kind of like to do, is like sort of emulating physical musicians playing electronic music, because that's a little bit my background.
Yeah.
So yeah, why this is cool, it kind of creates push and pull, also kind of creates this feeling of ghost notes. You can maybe do something as well on a more meatier element of the drums, maybe like a kick. So I'll just add one kick in here, which you can hear. Let's add something more broken. And then what I'll do is use a little bit of a volume reduction on some of the steps, just so you get a little bit of a...
almost like
a
side chain thing.
Exactly. You get a little bit of a ghost note effect. So this is kind of it. I'll bring back in the random industrial samples. So then again, you start to get something interesting, and let's remember these patterns are just 16 steps, and in fact, some of the patterns are just 5 steps. It's quite simple techniques, but ultimately quite interesting. I think another thing to look at would maybe be probabilities as well. Probabilities really help you to add super unpredictable variations. So maybe what I'll do is I'm gonna turn off the industrial samples, and we can move over to the Digitone. So I have some empty pattern here. So there's nothing here in this pattern. I'm gonna select this sound. Maybe something that I've made myself. What about this one here? Cool. So I'll just add some notes in here. And then what I can do is actually use the trigger menu here on the Digitone to essentially allow the machine to decide whether or not to play the step.
So like a probability programming.
Exactly. Yeah. It's the way it works is that each time through the loop, the machine will kind of roll a dice and then figure out which notes to play.
So I think actually with the very latest update, they also added it to the rhythm.
Exactly.
I think a couple of days ago. Actually.
Yeah, exactly. So this thing is, I find super useful. So if I go here, trigger, and I'm just gonna add some completely random probabilities. Play pause. So then you can start to hear it already. Now, another thing that I find useful as well, because we have the probabilities, is to use what's called parameter locking on the Electron machines. So parameter locking is essentially per step automation. So people are familiar with automation in something like Ableton Live or their favorite DAW. You can basically do the same thing but per step on these Electron machines. So why don't we mess with the oscillator per step? Now we have random oscillation.
Assigned to only some of
the steps. Exactly, assigned to some of the steps.
Yeah.
So now you have, I just open the filter a bit, something a little bit more interesting. Add some of the samples back in. Maybe open this a little bit up. I'm gonna add a sub here as well. So now you kind of have you know, a pattern that I don't know if it sounds good, but it definitely doesn't sound boring.
Yeah, super interesting stuff.
I think that's
super organic already. Yeah,
of course. So we looked a little bit at, I guess, conditional trigs, as they're called. So the probabilities. I think really the interesting thing about this is, as I said, we're trying to kind of mimic human behavior, human playing, almost as a drummer playing in a studio, whether they miss a hit of a hi-hat or whether they accidentally play an extra note. And those kind of happy accidents that just end up sounding really cool. And to be honest, like, what I would say is a really great technique is to just play the automation yourself. Don't draw a line in Ableton Live. I guess just play it like a guitarist would, play it like a drummer would. And you know, you can do that really simply just by moving the knobs yourself. And I think this is something that's kind of an obvious technique, but recording 6-7 minute long takes in the same way, you know, that a great singer would do in the studio. I really think that's important, at least for my workflow. Just like kind of tweaking the knobs, and that also fills in for my live as well. So, so yeah, I think really the point is to inject like a performance almost into the audio or into the playing of it. So yeah, I guess now we have quite an interesting sounding pattern. And yeah, I think, you know, once you have a solid 16-bar loop, using some of these techniques to spice it up, maybe make it not sound like a 16-bar loop, maybe make it sound like a longer kind of thing. So I find these techniques really useful for arranging and building changes over time that keep people interested in listening. And yeah, I think using these techniques to communicate your musical idea in different ways is kind of the way that I go around it.
Yeah, it's super interesting because it's not only applicable to techno, of course, because it's such a loop-based music, it applies really well for techno, but you could use this theoretically for any kind of genre.
Absolutely. And that's really the point. That's my background being someone who would play physical instruments, like traditional physical instruments, at least guitars, drums, keyboards. So that's the kind of thing that I know, and I think that's what I've kind of taken across from here. So yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. Some like small tips, but I guess anyone who's like starting out, as I was a couple years ago, might find this interesting. And I would be super happy to answer any questions in the comments.
Exactly. So if you have any questions at home, just let us know in the comments and you're gonna answer them personally.
Absolutely.
All right. That's the one. Cool. Then thanks for coming by. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time. Peace out.